fresh graduate from school, you're yet to get your first corporate job, so you are looking for a job or you're looking at a company that is going to employ you, so you do not make some really wonderful mistakes, if you know what I mean. We're going to be talking about things to look out for before you get your first corporate job. So let's go into the video. Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Grace Alagbe, and if you're new to this channel, you are most welcome. On this channel, we talk about career, lifestyle, faith, and relationships. Okay, you guys are good. Hope you guys are fine. So, you know, one thing I've realized is as fresh graduates, you just want to get your first job and, you know, start earning your 6 digits or 7 digits because, you know, there's a lot out there for you. The good thing about fresh graduates is whenever we enter the market or whenever you're in the market, you've entered the labor market, you are really excited and doing exploits and, you know, you really want to start earning and doing all of that. So you just jump into the jobs. Or into the work, and then you do not even realize that there are some things you were supposed to look out for before you start. And so in this video, I'll be taking you through some things you should look out for before you get your first job. The first thing you should look out for is your job progression. People know it also as career growth. Look out for your career growth. Now, whenever you are a job interview, you know, at the beginning, they'll ask you a lot of questions, and then at the end, they'll ask you, do you have any question? The best question to ask at that moment is not the salary you're going to be getting, but the first question you should ask is, what is the company's goal or what is their plan towards your career growth? Now, definitely the company is not going to do everything for you to grow your career, but the company should have benchmarks and have milestones that you should achieve, organize programs for you to attend and all of this for you to achieve a career growth or for you to, you know, in your career line continue to grow, so you don't just remain stagnant and, like I'll term it here, you don't become a local champion at your office and feel like you know everything when you literally do not know anything. Be intentional about your career growth before starting any job or taking any job. Tip 2 is the job culture. What is the job culture? What's the culture of the environment or of the office you're going to be working in? You know, sometimes it's not really easy to know these things, but at the beginning of your job, you should know, how many hours will I be working in a week? How many hours will I be working in a day? If I work extra hours, am I going to get paid? You need to make all these things clear. Are you going to have time to do other things? Now, one mistake we make as fresh graduates, or that is made, commonly made as fresh graduates, is immediately you get a job, you know, you want to put your all into the job to, you know, do very well, to stand out, and then you forget that you have another life somewhere waiting for you and it's depreciating. So you do not even focus on that other aspect of your life. You just focus on going to work, coming back, going to work, coming back, and then you have this regimented lifestyle before you know you start getting bored. So to avoid getting bored, the other parts of your life have to be active. So you really need to know your job culture. Are you going to be going to work every day? Are you going to be staying over at work? Is it going to be comfortable for you? Will it affect your family, how you relate with your family and friends? And then you do not even have time to network with other people. You need to start assessing all these things before you get your first job. Do not make the mistake, unless at the end of the day you start regretting why you took the job, or you stop being comfortable or happy with your job, and then you stop earning or feeling the sense of satisfaction with your job. So to avoid all of that, you need to, you know, ask the right questions at the beginning. Also, under the job culture, we also need to look at the area of gender inequality. You need to know, these people here, do they really respect both genders? Or when it comes to, you know, there are actually some companies where the ladies matter more than the men, and it shouldn't be so. So we need to know, you need to know, how do they carry ladies? Is there racism? Is there a part where the ladies cannot talk and men are expected to talk? Is the culture okay? But I want you to know something, it's not so easy to change the job culture of a company rather you could avoid it or state your values before you go into the company. So the third tip I'm going to be giving us is your health. I really don't know how to emphasize this or overemphasize this, but your health is major. One thing is, if you leave the world today, if you get sick today, or if something serious happens to somebody in a company and the person is not able to be at work in the next week, the job or the company will look for somebody else to fill in that position. So you need to take care of your health. You need to eat healthy, you need to sleep early, you need to have a healthy lifestyle, unless you will die slowly because you're not doing everything healthy. You get right? So you need to really live a healthy lifestyle. Don't negotiate anything that compromises with your health. Evaluate your skills, place value on yourself, do your best, and be your best in your position. So if you like the content I just dished out today, please make sure you give this video a very big thumbs up. Drop your comment below. What other suggestions or what other things do you think fresh graduates or people who have yet to get their first corporate job look out for in the society we are today? So see you on our next video, same time, same station, next week. Bye guys.